Hey y'all, it's me again, Valerie, and welcome back to my yarn room. Yay! Okay, y'all see this cute little thing I got in front of me here? It is so adorable. It's got little beads on it that spin. It's a keychain. And it's crochet. Now, this little bead here, I had one extra, so I just hooked it right there, but it spins as well. So you can spin it with your thumb and spin these here as well. So it's like a two-hand thing. Anyway. Y'all want to learn how to make these? They are so easy. And kids love them. They're like keychain fidgets. Plus, we putting beads on crochet. All right. If you haven't already, I'd appreciate if you hit that subscribe. When you do, give us a thumbs up. Share if you can. And leave me a comment. Love reading y'all's comments. And I seriously try to get back to every single one. Okay. For this project, if I can get my crochet hook, it's down in the bottom of my bag that I've been using. Oh, hold on a minute. All right, I'm back. Now, what I was going to say is, for this project, I already have my beads on my yarn, but I'm going to show you with one bead how you can put the beads on the yarn. Now, I'm using a 3.5 clover hook because the bead that I'm using is one of them ponytail beads, and I got them beads at $1.25 tree, and the bead goes straight over onto the hook. No hesitation, just straight on the hook. Okay, so the way I put my beads on my yarn, I took my bead and put it on my hook. Then I took my yarn and did it like that, and then I just pushed my bead right on over. And boom, bead on yarn. All right, and the reason why I'm using this light purple is because, well, Easter's right around the corner. So if you got like preteens or teens that have house keys, this is a good way to keep that house key, is put it on a keychain. All right. For this project, I have 12 beads on my yarn, and I'm going to use all 12. I'm going to start, if I can get my fingers to work right, I'm going to start with a slip knot. All right, and I'm going to chain 5. Because one is going to be a turning chain, and you're usually going to have 4 across. Now, you can do this any way you want. I just prefer doing it this way. You can put as many beads or as few beads as you want. I'm going to go into the second loop from the hook. I'm going to work a single crochet. Okay. Now, I'm going to put a single crochet in every single one. Which should give me 4 single crochets. Okay. Okay, and then I'm going to chain one, and I'm going to turn. Okay, that gives me like a little foundation there to start working on. Alright, so I'm going to go into that very first one, and I'll put a single crochet. Well, then, I'm going to chain two. I'm pulling a little bit of a loop there. Take my hook off. And I'm going to work two of my beads over on that. But I'm going to do it one at a time. I'm going to take it and put my hook right through the bead. Grab that loop. And just pull it straight on down. So, I'm going to put my hook through my bead. And I'm going to grab my loop there. And I'm going to work my bead. Sometimes, they get kind of canty-cornered. And, you got to actually work with it to get it to do it. But you put your two beads over your chain two. Then you put your hook right on back in that. And you come over here to your last one. If I can get my fingers and my yarn to work together. And I'm going to work a single crochet. And then I'm going to chain one. And I'm going to turn. Alright, and I already have two beads on there, but now this row, I'm going to go into the first one, and I'm going to put a single crochet, and then I'm going to chain two, and then I'm going to jump right over here to this last one. And I'm going to go in it, and I'm going to work a single crochet. And then I'm going to chain one. Now that puts yarn in between your section of beads. And they still spin pretty freely too. Okay, so then I'm going to turn, and I'm going to do another row of beads because I got yarn in between there. So, I'm going to go into the first one, and I'm going to put a single crochet. And then I'm going to chain two, because that gives me a foundation right there to put my beads on. So, pull up a little bit of a loop there, and I'm going to get my next two beads. And I'm going to work them down the yarn. Alright, I'm going to go into the first one closest to the loop. Like I said, sometimes you got to kind of work with it because sometimes they like to get stuck. And then I'm going to pull it straight on down. Okay. And then I'm going to pull up my next one and put my hook through right there. And I'm going to grab my little loop-de-doo. And I'm going to pull it straight on down. Okay. Then I'm going to put my hook back in my yarn. And I'm going to come right over here to this last single. And I'm going to put a single. And then I'm going to chain one. And I'm going to turn. See where I'm going with this? Every other row, you're going to add two beads. Or however many you want. And I'm going to go in that first one and put a single crochet. And then I'm going to chain two. And then I'm going to jump right over here to this last one. And I'm going to work a single crochet. Now I'm going to chain one and I'm going to turn. And that's all it is to it with adding beads to yarn. I don't know, you might have an easier way to do it, but that's how I put the beads actually on the yarn work. Now, all I did was after I added my beads, I just went and did a few rows of single crochet. I just put that bead there just for fun. I went ahead and folded my work around my keychain. And I just whip stitched it. And boom. You have a fidget keychain. All right. That's going to be all for this one. And I will meet you back here in the next one for another grand adventure right here in Val's Yarn Room. And never forget the yay! You can tell I'm feeling better, huh? Yep, next week should be a full week. I got a few things planned. Just working out the kinks. All right. Y'all leave me a comment. Let me know how you feel about these putting beads on yarn. Like I said, with these beads, the 3.5 millimeter E-hook clover is what I use. Works just great. Might want to use a different hook, because this one's not an inline. It's more like the shape of a boy hook. An inline would be more like a Susan Bates hook. But anyway. All right. Love each and every single one of y'all to pieces. Do something nice for somebody, even if it's just a smile. All right. Bye, y'all.